The first app I want to talk about is called Walpy. It's a pretty interesting wallpaper app for a couple of reasons. First, it's got quite a fresh load of unique and new wallpapers that I don't see in other commonly known wallpaper apps. Second, I love the categorization they've created. That Asian life, summer tropical spring, striking city views, you know, very uniquely named and resonate very well with the way photographers take and organize their pictures. And it's also got a pool of pictures from Unsplash where, you know, I mean, they've got very pretty pictures. Now, there are some interesting settings in here too that might get you a bit interested. You can set wallpaper to change automatically when certain conditions are met. I mean, that's pretty neat. I mean, you know, every time you open your phone and after some time you've got a new wallpaper, and you can set conditions whether, you know, that can happen only when idle or when on Wi-Fi. You can set the blur level, and you can also set how frequently you want those wallpapers to change. And you can also, you know, enable dark UI or the bright UI. Now, setting up a wallpaper is simple. Open the wallpaper that you like, set the blur level, and then You can also save it to device or apply it straight from the app. The second app is called Saver that will help you save Instagram videos and images onto your phone. Just hit copy link on the Instagram app, and from there you can save the image, save the video. You can even copy all content or just copy the hashtags and save it onto your phone. And guys, before we move on to the third app, it'll be great if you guys could just give a thumbs up to the video and subscribe to my channel. I'm really trying hard to get to 100,000 subscribers really quick. Next up is Hermit, which can replace your large native apps with web-based light apps. For example, Facebook app is a 50 MB installation and can take easily about 190 MB on your phone after installation. This entire experience could be replaced by a simple web-based light app that Hermit creates for you right on your home screen, and it's just a 3 MB installation and 34 MB after installation. You could do this for a variety of applications, and it's not just limited to social media. I mean, it's got plenty of popular apps that you might be using on a day-to-day basis, and that includes, you know, a couple of dating web apps, technology apps. You know, you've got Android Central, you've got Inan Tech, you've got all your shopping apps like Flipkart, Best Buy, eBay, Groupon. So yeah, I mean, you get the hint, right? I mean, you've got all your popular apps. You can use them on your smartphone without really installing their particular app. Imagine the amount of space that you can store, and you can keep your phone fresh and fast. And let me show you an example. So let's say I take Facebook and add it automatically onto my home screen. Now, when I go into my home screen, I've got Facebook. Now, you get to set individual preferences of how you want your experience on this particular web-based light app. The theme, the font size. I mean, you pretty much get an absolutely replicated experience of Facebook, but with preferences of your own. So for example, I just enabled the dark mode. That's not available in the Facebook app, but you get the Facebook app experience using Hermit with your preferences. And your preferences are quite unlimited. I mean, you've got a cozy nighttime reading, you've got a reader mode, you can block pop-ups, you can change the font size. You can also go to a full screen experience that makes it even more app-like. And guys, the customizations don't stop there. I mean, if you go into more customizations, you can actually change a lot more things to make the performance of that web-based light app even better. I mean, you know, you could disable or enable data saver mode if you want to save data. You could disable JavaScript so your pages load faster. And the best part is all of these preferences that you set are for that Facebook web-based light app. And you can have completely different settings for another web-based light app that you might create. Next is Fast Key Launcher. I mean, if you open and launch apps pretty often or make calls quite often, this app is perfect. With just a few taps, you can narrow down to your required app or contact that you're looking for and action it immediately. And it's also fast because it's on your home screen. So you can still, you know, have access to all your apps, but just use the keyboard to launch whatever you want. If you're an Android user, you're possibly just using your navigation bar at the bottom to go, you know, back to tap on home or to open recent apps. You could actually change all of that and completely have a new experience, if you're bored of this one, that is, by installing what is called the X Home Bar Free. Okay, and what that does is it gives you this tiny sleek bar that you could just swipe left, right, up, or you could tap, double tap to make it do a couple of things, and you can configure all of that, obviously. But first, you need to get rid of the navigation bar so it looks cooler. So go into your settings. I'm sure if you've got Android O, you have this, feature available. So just go ahead and disable it. So you just have your action bar, which is the X home bar. The navigation bar shows up on the home screen, but don't worry about it. It won't show in apps. Okay. Now, before you really use it, go into X home bar. You need to configure your new X home bar. So select actions that you want to perform depending on how you swipe it. So, you know, the general, you want back, you want home, and you want recent apps. Other than that, you could also, if you get the pro version, get more features. So for example, double tapping on this X home bar could take a screenshot, or single tap could lock the screen, or you could create a split screen. And you also get options to customize the color, the placement, the thickness, and even the vibration strength of this particular bar. The sixth app on the list is called NotiSave, and essentially what it does is it just helps you not get distracted from all the notifications that keep coming onto your phone. I mean, with all the Instagram messaging, the notifications, the WhatsApp groups that keep buzzing, you don't need to have all of that coming in. At the same time, you don't want to miss them, right? You want to be able to look at them later. That's when NotiSave comes into play. It clubs all of your notifications by all of these, you know, chat or whether they're social or whether they're a finance-based app, and it clubs it together so you can go and see them later. And you could enable this for a few apps, disable it for a few apps. It's completely your choice, so go ahead and try it out. And the last one on the list is a game that I personally think is one of the best games that I've ever played on Android. It's called Do It. It might look tough on the screen right now because I'm probably playing a slightly more advanced level, but trust me, it takes you progressively. You know, it starts from a simple level and then you learn along the way. The good part is it's got a huge storyline, so you've got a bunch of episodes or a bunch of levels to play. There are also more to unlock. You can pay a small price and get more levels if you want. There's also a challenge mode. So yeah, I mean, it's really, really engaging. And definitely play this game with your earphones on, because the music on this is trippy. It's really, really good. And really, it's not one of those games that you'll just get bored of. As I said, there are multiple challenges, there's a full epilogue that you can play, and you can just unlock more. Yeah, so that's it guys for all the apps that I wanted to talk about that you must try in the month of May. If you've got any questions, any suggestions, feel free to comment them in the section below. Again, do not forget to subscribe, and do leave me a thumbs up if you really, really like the video. Thank you guys, and see you in the next one.